features of MNC, features of multinational company. So here first we'll know about the features. So here chain size, as I told, multinational companies they are very large. Actually their operations is also very large and the sale is also very large, and they operate in big scale operations. It is a very large scale operations. A multinational companies not only operate in one country, they operate in other more than one countries. They have to do a business with large scale operations. They have to involve in lot of processes. They have to involve in lot of transactions. Definitely their services and their sale is also in large scale. So they are in very giant size. We can call it as they are in big size. And here a domestic company, when we compare with the domestic companies, it is more than a domestic company which doesn't have, which is operating in only one country. So when we compare with this MNC and domestic company, definitely it is very large in operation. The operations is very large and the profits of this also very huge. The profits of is also when we compare with these profits are physical assets. The assets is also very large when we compare with the other companies. So when we compare with these assets or profits of one MNC company of that country, and that country is developing country, their GDP will be very less when we compare with these assets and profits of this MNC company. So that is how you can take an example of IBM. IBM has, the physical assets are $8 billion. So that is what the their assets value. So here they will always participate in big scale of operations. So that is why it is one of the feature of MNC is that is chain size in nature. The everything whatever they do, that is in big nature only, that is in some big size. They will do in a big sizes, large scale industries, large scale operations. So whatever they do, whatever the business activity they will do in very large sense, broader sense. And next we'll move to the another feature, that is the international operations. So as I specified, it is MNC multinational corporations, multinational companies operate in more than one country. Definitely they have to do international operations. They have to participate in not only one company, they have to participate in more than one country. So here they will do international operations. They will participate in the international operations. If home country is there, so if Coca-Cola is there, so they will do their operations through the subsidiaries. There will be different branches in other countries. With the branches and subsidiaries, they will sell their products, they will do their operations, they will do their business activities. So that is how they will always participate in the international operations. Then we move forward to the professional management. So as I told, it has a lot of it is participating. MNCs participate in large scale operations. They always have a professional management. Whoever working in their company, they are experts. They are specialized in that. They have specialized managers. They have a specialized people, individuals working in their company. They always want to have a professional management. The MNCs always try to recruit expert individuals only in their company, because they want to know about the technology advancement. Because their operations are not limited to one country. They operate in more than one country. So definitely they want specialized people only to work there. So not only that, they will provide the different training sessions for the technology enhancement. So for their employees, they will provide lot of training for that when there is a technology advancement, and they will know about the market advancement. Market, if the market is changing, they have to know about the market information. So that is why they will opt only professional management only, professional people only, professional individuals only they will recruit. So in that sense, that this is a basic feature. This is the most important features that MNC will have only professional management. They won't encourage the unprofessionals. So that is a basic feature. Next, centralized control. So as I told, it is operating in not only one country, another country, but the control is in only one country. So here it is considered as a centralized control. The system is like a centralized control, only one country where the headquarters is there, home country. So they will only control all the operations, even though their operations is widely spread, but their operations is controlled by only one country, so that is home country. So here we can call it as the nature of this MNC is centralized control. So only they can take any decisions, not this host country will take. So here what are the management decisions? So they have to, the only only home country has to take. So here it is considered as a centralized control. And oligopolistic powers. So here oligopoly powers means, here the problem is power of control is in only few hands. Here being a giant size, here the problem will be they will acquire all the competing companies, and they have the problem is it will go towards the monopolistic nature in the market. So here there will be no competitors for these MNCs, because they are very big in nature, very large. They will do large scale operations. They have a very huge profits, huge assets. With that, definitely they will acquire the small companies. With that, definitely the power of control will be in some hands only. That is also the problem. So the oligopolistic powers. So here it will be like only the MNC companies doesn't have any market competitors. They want to grab the market share. They always want to increase their market share. So that is how it happens. That is how its nature of a MNCs. Next, sophisticated technology. So this is also one of the major feature of a MNCs. So they will use sophisticated technology. They will import the sophisticated technology. They will use that technology advancement. They are the first persons who will use the sophisticated technology. They will use for their productive uses. They will facilitate the because they will be operating in developed countries and underdeveloped countries. So they will facilitate that sophisticated technology to that underdeveloped countries also. That is what they will do. So it is one of the basic features of MNCs, that is they will use sophisticated technology only. So this is what the features of MNCs.